see that I've cut these ridges along here. That's the approximate underside foil shape. I'm sanding them down. I want a 3mm back edge, sorry, a 5mm back edge, because 5mm is the thickness of the foam board we're using as the control surfaces. So you mark these, you sand these ridges out down to where you think the right level is, getting your gradient all the way through to nearly this line. Remember, you want to leave this line here, or these lines all the way around. You want to leave them on the foam until you've nearly got to them. That way you know you're pretty close to your foil shape that you need. So once these ridges are in, I can just sand across them until I hit them, and then I know the whole surface is fairly good. So even though this is not a true blended body wing, because the chassis is not really wide enough, I'd really want to make the chassis about this wide if I was going to do a blended body wing to get a decent amount of lift out of the fuselage. So here, I'm still using it as a blended body wing of sorts, that I'm making the airfoil of the central fuselage the same proportions as the main airfoil, that being the 12.5% thickness, with the thick point at 30% back. In this case, 30% back is just about just behind that front edge of that foam. So chopping that off there, there'll be a bit of a step because we're leaving space to attach the vertical stabilizer. And this is a new method for cutting this foam. Let's put my mask on. I'll use just a normal saw.
So I'm starting to take shape now. The line is up approximately. There's the base wing. So we'll stick that all together. I've still got to shape the tailplane, but yeah.